Hey, good afternoon, everybody. We had a fairly productive day today. It's Sunday. We had church. We made some face masks, and we got to meet some friends. So we'll tell you all a little bit more about that coming up.
Right after this. Hi, everybody. I'm Judy.
And I'm Jim, and welcome to It's a Highway Vlog, where you get to travel the country with us, and you don't even have to leave your sewing kit at the house.
So, while you're out here trying to sew those masks up,
don't forget to like our videos, subscribe to our channel, click the subscribe button, and don't forget to
ring that notification bell.
So you don't miss anything. So you don't miss anything.
So, get it? So.
Hey, good Sunday afternoon, everybody, even though it sort of feels like a Saturday to me, but it is a Sunday. Well, we don't have a load tomorrow, so normally, you know, we have a load Tuesday.
Yep, and guess what that does? It just prolongs, oh, we'll do that tomorrow.
Yes.
Oh, we'll do that tomorrow, because it's not really Sunday. It's not really.
We have another
day to do whatever.
Yes, so welcome to the Procrastination Channel.
They probably haven't already noticed that yet.
Yes. Great things to put off stuff till the next day. So anyway, we are still here in Ohio.
Yeah.
We got up this morning and watched our church services on our laptop, a couple of those. And so that seems to be the new normal for us now, that we watch church on TV.
Well, what was kind of cool today is our Lutheran church at home. The Lutheran church has a hierarchy, and there's what they call a synod, and the synod, which is a combination of a bunch of our churches together, they actually did the service today and then posted online, which was really kind of cool because we saw a previous pastor of ours and their kids that they were doing the children's sermon, so that was really neat. And then we got, and that was all about scares and scars, which I thought was a cool title.
Wow.
Scares and scars. Yeah.
So we did that this morning, and then we got a little bit of a surprise this afternoon. This afternoon? Was it?
It was close.
Noon.
It was around noon.
We have a friends of ours that drive for FedEx, live like here. And so really close, like within 10 miles of the truck stop. And
oh, you know why I know what time it was?
Why?
Because Judy and I were over there beside the truck and my watch went off, and it's my alarm that goes off that says God is with me wherever I go. I have that go off at noon every day. So that's how come I know what time it was. Just a little interruption.
So anyway, we have friends that live nearby, and they were finishing up a load, and they were actually on their way home, and so they stopped, and we managed to keep our distance, although it was hard, because they hug, you know, like we hug.
It's like, so we were hugging from a distance.
There
so
was no hugging.
And I have a couple pictures I need to throw out there.
Yeah, and so we got to see them. They were actually on one of our vlogs once. We met them up in Bordentown one night, and so we got to go out to eat lunch with them. I think it might be the first time we've seen them since then.
Yeah.
And that was back
in the
fall.
And they actually live in the same state as we do.
Yeah, it's really weird. And so close by, you know, in normal times, we would be here over the weekend. We've went over to their house. We've went out to eat.
Gone to church with them.
Went to church with them. That's probably what we would have probably have done this weekend. But no, we're stuck in a truck stop. Stuck in a truck. Anyway.
We've probably gone in and eaten Popeyes or gone to Golden Corral or
someplace. But it was nice seeing them. I mean, you know, we kept our distance. Really, we did. We kept our distance. We didn't get close to them. We were 10 foot apart or whatever.
And they had two new puppies.
They had new puppies.
Well, they were born in December.
Yes.
And they were, I can't remember what the Pomeranian.
They were very small. A Pomeranian and something else. They were small little dogs.
Just like this big.
Yeah, mini dogs. And we got to see those out running and playing. They were here for probably half an hour. Got to see those people. It was really nice to see Ralph and Judy.
Yeah.
Always enjoy seeing them. And so that was sort of the highlight of our weekend. Now, you know, the rest of it's just no. No, we had a really good time yesterday. Yesterday was like live YouTube day. We had it was just like all day long, everybody kept doing live videos. All the expediting trucking channels most of them that, you know, that we follow and we know those folks, they had, you know, like a live video, like, first started off with, Frank and Stephanie, the trucking couple. They did a live video, and there was another couple on there that have a vlog, Longshire's Expediting. They were on there, and then later on we had Trucking with Mr. Coach, they have a YouTube channel, and go check all these channels out. They had a live video, and then they got off, and then we did our 2-hour marathon live video. We never know how long those things are going to last. And so last night it lasted for 1 hour, 59 minutes, and 50 seconds.
Yes, because Jim couldn't wait until that last 30 seconds.
10 seconds, and we'd have 2 hours.
Whatever it was.
So then we got off that, and I was sitting here.
You got
a
notification.
Got a notification, and then there's another.
Truck and Travel.
Truck and Travel. Derek and Cinnamon, we know those folks, and they were having a live video. So we got on there, and we sort of chatted back and forth on all of them, and so it was sort of interesting. And then I think as I went to bed, I'm not really for sure if Frank and Stephanie put out another video, another live, or whether they just replayed the one from earlier. So there was another one. I'm just like, I am sleepy. I got to go to sleep. So I didn't stay up and watch that. So sorry about that.
Yeah. I think you ducked out of Derek and Cinnamon's at the Truck and Travel one.
Yes.
A little early,
yeah,
too.
I was ready to go to bed when we finished ours. And then, like, half
an
hour
later. Truck and Travel's on.
But it's really neat to be able to, you know, there was a lot of information exchanged hands on all of the lives yesterday, you know, from questions about getting your CDLs when, you know, how do you do that when none of the license bureaus are open, or, you know, have people, shippers been wanting you to wear masks, and just the flow of information. It's nice with the YouTube channels that everybody gets.
What was really cool
out.
Is they all had, everybody was doing things, sharing different types of information,
right?
You know, and it's really kind of neat, because I think Frank said this on one of his live videos, is that we've got this whole community of YouTubers and people who watch YouTube, and it's a different community, but it's so nice to be able to chat live and talk to each other,
right?
Live, it's really kind of neat to do that, which we were slow going on doing the whole live thing, but it's just really, really nice. And
I don't
we're
have
nice to,
edit. To
each other.
that's the bonus, no editing.
Yeah.
And so, but yeah, those are fun to do, and we sort of did a little bit of that last Saturday, so I don't know if this is going to become a thing or not. Like, you know what, it's Saturday, it's Live Expediters Day. Which has been that way for a couple of weeks, but it is really neat to be able to do that. And there were some folks that were in and chatting on each one of these. I mean, there was people that were on from the first one all the way up to the last one.
Yeah, that's what I said. It's a community. It's a really neat, you know.
And so people that are getting ready to start, people that have been doing this for literally 30 years, that were here at the Roberts Day.
You know who you are.
and folks like us that have been here, you know, Frank and Stephanie have been here for like 5 years. We've been here for almost 9. You know, Danny and Stephanie have been here for 2, almost a year, and Truck and Travel, those guys have been here for about a half a year now.
Yeah.
And so
they did another business before this.
Yeah, you get all kinds of different levels of experience, and, you know, everybody's got a little bit of a different viewpoint, and it's just nice to be able to do those. I really like doing the lives. You get to interact with the folks more so than this. I mean, we're literally sitting here in the sleeper of our truck talking to our phone.
I'm talking to the microphone.
If somebody looked in, they would go, what are you people doing?
It's just like when you have your headpiece on, when you wear those ones that are just in your ear, and you walk around and you're talking to someone, you know, obviously on the phone, but it looks like, you know, when those first came out, you were just wondering, okay, is there's something wrong with that person where they're talking to themselves all the time, or do they need to hear themselves, you know, out loud all the time? And then you realize they're on the phone.
Right.
You know?
Right. Well, we're obviously, people would say that about us. Is there something wrong with them people? They talk on their phones all the time.
No, what it is we like to hear ourselves talk.
Right.
That's what it is.
Right. So, that was pretty cool yesterday. We got to do that. And today, we actually have been somewhat productive.
Yes. First production was you got your QuickBooks moved from one computer to the next,
right,
which is a task in itself.
Task in itself. I'm finally in the process of moving my old QuickBooks program from the old laptop I had months ago and have had for years in onto my new one, because my plan was to keep doing QuickBooks on the old one, but that old one is so slow. And I like the new one, so, and I've got plenty of room on the new one, so I'll just move it over.
And he had time to think about it, and then again, if you took the time to do that, then the paperwork is still there.
It's one step closer to being finished. I accomplished another step today.
There was one step accomplished, because then, well, I pulled you away to do something else, so that was...
On a somewhat more serious note, a little bit, one of the questions that kept coming up yesterday on all of the live videos were, have you ran into places that are now requiring you to wear a mask?
The answer is yes.
Yes, we did. We ran into a place in downtown Philadelphia where they asked and told us that we needed to wear a mask. And luckily, we had bought some
material,
and so we just tied it around our faces, and you know, and it worked, and that was fine. So we sat around the day, and...
Well, can I interject? The problem I had,
anyway,
I had with the material, and it was just like a bandana kind of size, I guess is what it was, but when you tie it in the back, it always comes apart, mm-hmm. and it always just starts falling off while you're trying to do stuff, and it's just like, all right, we gotta figure out a different solution. So, go on.
So, we've been looking online, of course. I'm sure everybody else has been doing this too. We cannot find masks. I mean, that's just, we're not going to find them.
I don't think they're anywhere.
And we really would not want to take the good mask away from healthcare professionals anyway. These are just basically face coverings to help you prevent spreading the disease if you have it, more so than preventing you from getting it.
Although we think we've come up with a good solution for both ways.
Well, maybe. It's not going to take...
But they're not the 19 whatever...
The N95.
Yeah, thank you.
They're not anywhere near
there's
that.
There's a 9 in there somewhere.
So what we came up with, we looked online, and we of course...
And
we,
those need to go to the healthcare workers, by the way, if you have any of those, send those that way.
So we came up with a couple different things. We were looking online, and we had this material, and Judy bought needle and thread last week, and we thought, oh, we'll just sew some mask up.
Well, he decided not to. He said he was too impatient.
Okay, number one, I don't have a thimble, and my fingers would be, you know, bloody at the end of the whole thing. So
no thimble.
I knew how to sew, but I don't have a thimble.
A wimp.
It is a wimp. And so anyway, we came up with like we looked online. We found like a, it's just simply fabric, and you sort of accordion fold it up, and then you tape the ends. Since we didn't have a stapler.
Yeah, or they call for staplers.
Or we could have sewed. And so this
But we had packing tape, which is...
duct tape. It works for everything, right?
Duct tape.
And so we just sort of taped the ends, and we split this here, right here, and then put the rubber band in there and then taped around it, and it seems to work.
You also put a paper clip somewhere, didn't you?
There is a paper clip up here. Yeah, put it down on the table so you can't see. It's a secret. Oh, there's the paper clip right there, huh?
Oh, obviously it didn't stay in.
But you're supposed to put a paper clip up here in the top, straightened out, so you can pinch your nose. So anyway, this thing just sort of fits over your mouth. Like so. And it does.
Beautiful!
You know, so we
got
this.
And we have these big, huge rubber bands. We don't know where we got them from, but we have a bunch of them.
And so I feel that this would be pretty, you know, pretty decent. And so we made one of those today. The only thing that Judy sort of pointed out was it would be hard to wash that. And then the fabric itself is pretty thin, and we had been going online and the blue shop towels that you can just buy.
You can make some of those too.
You make some of those. They
actually, they say those are really good for keeping them out. But...
We put like lined one inside, and so you just sort of stuff it in there. I mean, it's nothing, you know, it's just sort of...
It's fancy, folks. Don't you see? It's fancy.
Yeah, it is really fancy. We also made some out of
just the shop towels.
The shop towels. Sort of, again, accordion fold. They sort of pull apart, you know, and then they go back. We don't know how long these will last. These are, you know, these are shop towels. You get them wet, you know, whatever. So we made a couple of those. And then Judy had found this design online. And, it's just,
which is really
no staples, no tape, no
nothing. Nothing. I'll show what you guys saw. What we started out with before.
Yeah, you got to hold up so they can see, huh?
See, this is fabric.
It's a black cloth.
See, can you see?
And you can see through it.
Yep, you can see through it, but it's also going to be doubled over. So you got to. fold it one way. Of course, I'm using black. So, and then fold the other side to meet that side, like so. And then you take two rubber bands and just put it on the side here, somewhere like that. And then you put the other one on the other side, somewhere like that. And then the key with this is to try to get the rubber bands to match where your ears go or wherever. So, and
sort of a trial by error.
Yeah, there's a trial by error. So you got to put like that. And then I shoved this in here somewhere, something like that.
These are just for, you know, like if you have to have a face covering, well, here's a face covering.
Yep.
And you can readjust after you get it on your face. Please do.
So something like that. That was showing you quick.
And look at that. Ta-da. So stylish.
Ta-da.
It's what all.
And then those other rubber bands just go around your ear. But then you can just take it off and wash the fabric when you're done.
It's what all the fashionable expediters are wearing this year. So, the next time we get together,
we're going to have a runway. And we'll just walk down with all of our different masks. Of course, 6 feet apart.
Fashion
show of masks.
So welcome, you know. Glad you enjoyed the expediting fashion show. We'll be back next year when, you know. Really sad thing. I have my grandmother's sewing machine at the house that's been sitting in the garage. It still works. It's an old Singer sewing machine. And like I said before, I know how to sew. And so if we were home and I had that thing, but we just don't have no room for it in the truck, or else we could actually bring it out and I could sew.
Some drivers who do have sewing machines. Yes, there are. Truck. They do. Actually, there was one, and I can't remember if we met them or if it was just someone sharing on Facebook, but they actually up front actually had a table that laid down that they could actually sew while they were riding in the passenger seat.
That might actually be an idea. We might actually bring that out at some point in time here. I like to sew.
Let's just get more stuff to put in the truck.
Well, that's the problem. You know, if we brought the sewing machine, we would have no room for us. So one of us would have to stay home. So anyway, that's what we've been doing today. We really sort of wish we could find some of those masks, but it's like one of those... Well, yeah, I'd like to have some, but the folks that really need it are not us, I don't think. Although it is important that we try to protect ourselves a little bit.
Yeah, and we really generally are not around a lot in the public.
No, we're not.
You know, what we do is go in from, you know, and all it takes is one person, everybody. You know, you all know that. But at the same time, we are not exposed to as many people as most everyone else would be if they were in.
Yeah, if we were working in a store or we were in, constant contact with people day in and day out. I mean, you know, there are days when I don't see anybody or talk to anyone, you know, unless we're delivering and then it's this one person and you're usually standing halfway across the dock from them. So, you know, this is for emergency stuff. You know, like we said last night, Pennsylvania put in an order yesterday where now everybody that goes in, they're wanting individual businesses, essential businesses that are still open, so like grocery stores and everything else, they're now relying on those businesses to enforce their, everybody's supposed to have a face mask on. Mm-hmm. So they, you know, technically they should not be allowing you inside the doors unless you've got, you know, something, you know, whether it's something made up like us or just a simple bandana or, you know, an actual, you know, full-on respirator.
And I know you all will, but just please be respectful of those associates and those people who are trying to enforce those rules. It's not with those people you need to take up if you don't agree with it. You know, just, and I know everybody will because it's just what we do right now. You know, we need to be conscious of everybody else and the stress that they're under too. So, you know.
I fixed that.
He's fixing my mask while I'm trying to be serious here.
So, hopefully these times will change soon. We don't know. So that's what we're doing over the weekend. Mm-hmm. I think we have enough masks for now for a little while. Maybe we'll have to make some more. They're pretty quick and easy, literally like 5 minutes. It's just
getting it to fit your head and your... That's what I said. It's not, they're not hard at all. It's just trying to make sure that... you get the size and the distance that's supposed to go around your ears and all that stuff.
Yeah, so, but anything else we want to talk about? It seems like we're missing something.
I don't know.
Don't really know.
If we do, Jim's going to cook some hamburgers later.
Oh, yeah.
And, hamburgers. Just for the record, the brownies we made yesterday, they're gone.
Yeah, they're all gone.
Let's just show raw meat on the...
If you're offended by raw meat, turn your head away now, because yep. I'm going to show some raw meat. We've got hamburger. This is hamburger patties we got from home.
Yes.
Yes. This is what I think it is.
Yes, it is. It's T-bone.
Yeah. T-bone.
So you're also dripping, so be careful.
T-bone steak.
Just water, I think.
So we'll have that probably later on tonight.
That's from our freezer at home to our freezer in the truck. And from our wonderful friends at Funkhauser Family Farms. Yep.
Upper Sandusky, Ohio.
Yeah, there you go. I went to high school with them.
Yeah, and it's farm-fed raised beef, and we'll have partake of that tonight.
Yes, yes.
We'll get to that as soon as I get done editing the vlog and probably get the grill out and cook that, and maybe some sausage, I don't know, for the upcoming week. We have a short week.
Might want to look at that one.
There was a load opportunity just came across that we're probably going to take a look at.
So we need to get off here.
We'll be finishing this one up and we'll see. We'll let you know tomorrow if we managed to get that load or whether we got the
not awarded,
which I'm guessing we'll be saying that. So I know where that load's going. So until then, everybody take care. Enjoy the rest of your weekend. Please be safe. Drive carefully. Subscribe to our channel. Don't forget to do that. Because a lot of folks are now doing it. It seems to be the end thing.
Like to.
Yes. And we'll see.
And ring that notification bell.
I always forget. We'll see you in the next video.
So long, everybody.
Good night.